there's a redemptive power that making a choice has, you know, rather than feeling like you're at effect to all the things that are happening. Make a choice, right? You just decide what it's going to be, who you're going to be, how you're going to do it. Just decide. And then from that point, the universe is going to get out your way.
In order to control the world, you must deceive the world. Or think about the past couple centuries and who's been in control of the world. The same little small group of people who are still in control of the world, who's convinced the rest of the world that they are the majority, which in fact, they are the minority globally. They make up 1/10, 1/11 of the global population. However, they've gave us this illusion that they are the majority, but they are the majority when it comes to genuine material wealth, power, control, government privileges, and luxuries. I read somewhere that the top 5 richest people in the world, who just happen to be white men, obviously, it goes to a couple thousand people before a black person. The point is, the top 5 richest people in the world put all their money together is more than all black people on earth. I just want to shed some light on just a few points. There's no people powerful as a people who know who they are. They know who they are. A lot of, in more recent times, a lot of whites don't know who they are. But that's new. That's new. They've been operating on one accord in unison and organized for centuries. Okay. They know who they are and became very, very powerful. Nothing more, no people more powerful than people who know who they are. Now, once we as blacks figure out our identity, once we have our proper identity, our biggest problem is solved. And we cease to identify ourselves geographically. African American, that cuts us off from all black people. You know what I mean? That's why they gave us that. Because before, when James Brown came out with the I'm Black and I'm Proud, black people all over, South America, Australia, Europe, Asia, Africa, they're like, oh, I'm black and I'm proud. Hell yeah. That was the first time I ever heard anyone being proud to be black. Just think about it. Think about if someone wanted to rewrite history right now. Completely say, forget everything that went on. This is history, and because I said what I, and this is what I said. The whole rest of the world has to abide by that. They give up what they're doing, a certain model as their history and structure. You have to forcefully take that. Like, imagine the amount of bloodshed that had to be done. They said, this is what it is because I said so, and just whatever. But listen, they gave us Christmas and they gave us Easter and all these other little different things because we're spiritual by nature. They gave us all these holidays and all these stories and these spooky stories because we're spiritual by nature. So they knew and they bred us to adopt their ways and their fabrications as our reality. They bred us to adopt their fabrication as our reality. Because when you strip people from all knowledge of anything, they realize that, you know, black people are more spiritual, so they start figuring out, they're like, ways. Oh, nah, that's too powerful. Forget all that. You know, the transition from Kunta Kinte to Toby. If you don't know what that is, then you need to check out. Black people have a mental illness. We don't have our righteous mind. Most black people, you know what I mean? Like, majority, like 98%, like, I would say like 90% of black people don't have their righteous mind because it was taken from them and then replaced with a fabricated mind. They were forced to fear God that their ancestors never feared. They were forced to adopt a completely different life or die and watch your children die and get killed. So it gets to a point where you're just like, okay, fuck it, I guess I just have to do it. So when we talk about freedom, when we talk about the resurrection, like, it's the resurrection of your mind. You have to be transformed by the renewing of your mind. That's how I'm in the position that I am now, and I made the transition that I did by renewing my mind. Words, reading words. By stretching my mind to new concepts and ideas. By questioning everything, and then researching everything that I question. By refining my own philosophy to enhance the quality of my life. or making a decision to be my own savior instead of just saying someone, believing someone because they say someone else is your savior, so you don't have to do anything. You don't have to, I know you're being oppressed and all that stuff, but you don't have to do anything about it. You got a savior, he's coming. Nah, that's not for me, right? I choose to be my own savior. I do understand when we talk about like spiritual liberation and spiritual empowerment, that there's nothing more important to a person than their perspective about their relationship to
or their fellowship with what they perceive to be God.
Nothing more important to a person than their perspective about their relationship to or their fellowship with what they perceive to be.
What they perceive to be as God or the goddess or the universe or whatever particular label,
the force that makes our blood flow and allows us to win. The force that feeds all the fishes and all the birds and all the animals. The force that keeps the earth spinning on its axis, gravity here, and oxygen, all these other things that allow me to breathe. That force that takes the subatomic particle.
You could fit 10,000 of them on the tip of a pin.
Most mainstream religions are very misogynistic. Misogyny says that it's the Father, the Son, and the Spirit, which I completely disagree. And from my research and my understanding, not how it works. There's nothing that birth without the presence or a female gene or whatever.
So you can't even have a son. You can't even have a son without the mother.
And that's the Holy Trinity. That father, that mother, father become one, and then the Spirit just creates.
The ancients knew this, which is why any depiction of black people or like any depiction of a king or a god in ancient or indigenous cultures, right next to him was a goddess or a queen.
Not smaller, not whatever. Oftentimes bigger. Oftentimes you would see the woman being praised.
Since DNA and science and everything,
all birth came from the first womb was a black womb, black woman's womb. So while we're worshiping a man, while neglecting the power of the womb and the, don't get me started. Discover your inner goddess, sisters, my beautiful black queens, discover your inner goddess.